How y'all doing? For this review, I'm going to go over book 2 of 11 of the John Carter series by Rice Burroughs, which I have in this copy here, Under the Moons of Mars. You know, doesn't matter which copy you have, one's good as the other. So, let's continue on where we left off. Now, I didn't tell the ending of the end of the first book, but I have to do that so you can follow along here. John Carter, trying to, after happily living for 9 years as a husband of Dejah Thoris, and, you know, now being a noble himself among the people of Helium. For 9 years, he's lived happily, and he's just right before his son was being born, the atmosphere of Mars is dying, so the atmosphere, this is all done by an atmosphere processor, which he encounters in the last book, and he goes over there, comes to try and fix it up, and when he does, he barely makes it, he saves Mars, but in so doing, he finds himself transported back into Earth. And upset as he is by that, he continues to find the gold where he left it from in the first book, and uses that to fund, you know, to try and find a way to get back on Mars. And he finally finds a way, and in doing so, part of his setup is to fake his own death. And all of his all the information that he knows of is now told to his to a relative of his, which is Edgar Rice Burroughs. Is one of those stories where real people are now used fictionally to explain how they got these stories, to give it a sense of plausibility. You find it sometimes, but I'm digressing. So, point is, Carter finds himself back on Mars. As he does, he finds himself in a very interesting looking valley along a river. Later finds out this is River Iss. See, Mars has, the inhabitants of Mars believes that those who, while they live long lives, 1,000 years, there are those who believe that if you go down to River Iss, when you're ready, and you haven't died in combat or anything, but you go down there, you come across the gods and come into paradise. So, but those who try and come back from that end up being killed. So, it's highly taboo to do that. You have to play with that here. So, Carter eventually finds out that's where he is. He finds out through this because he sees pilgrims, these green Martians, traveling down, and they are now instantly attacked by two monstrous creatures. One, the great white apes of Mars, savage creatures, white, have four arms, don't want to mess with them. And you have what's called the plant men of Mars, which are these plant-like beings that, they have mouths on the end of their arms with teeth. They try to suck the fluids out of their victims and what have you. So these pilgrims are now being attacked by them. John Carter helps, and the only survivor of that group is Tars Tarkas himself, his own Martian friend. So as they try to escape them, they eventually find out that the gods of Mars, who people are expected to meet, are not gods at all, just another group of Martians that pose as gods called the Therns. And the Holy Hecador is their leader, and basically what they do is they get people to go down this river, and those who survive, the apes and the plant man, become either as slaves or as food to the Therns themselves. And they do believe themselves to be gods of Mars as well. So it's a nice little setup they have there for their own ends. And the Therns are white-skinned. They appear to be blonde hair, but that's just wigs. They're actually bald. Now, while infiltrating the city here, they come across a slave girl named Thuvia, she was taken there as a young child. She grew up with them. She has an interesting ability. There is these huge, monstrous lion, eight-legged lion creatures called Bants. They send them out there to, they tried to send a few of those against Thuvia, and try to sick a little game with them. She finds out she has an ability to calm them down to where they won't hurt her. But, that's just an interesting little fact about them. And so, Thuvia helps Tars Tarkas and John Carter out. She explains to them what the Therns are all about. And while they're trying to escape, the Therns are attacked themselves by another group of Martians. These are pirates that come by, and they try to raid their stuff and try and steal any slaves that they can. And these are black-skinned pirates, they claim themselves to be the firstborn and therefore the superior of all the other Martian races, according to their own beliefs. So, if these two people think highly of themselves out to attacking each other, all for their own sense of superiority. And all the other Martian inhabitants are just unaware of that. So the Valley Door has the Therns, and there's a the Black Pirates, which they thought was on one of the, they believed on one of the moons of Mars. They actually live near the South Polar region in an underground city of Omion. Their leader poses as a goddess herself, Isis, and you know, and that's, you know, that's their setup there. So Carter, in the confusion of the Black Pirates have made the Therns, or he gets Deja Thoris and Tars Tarkas on a ship so they can fly away back towards Helium, and he finds and he goes onto another a vessel which has some of the Black Pirates that tries to carry away with whatever bounty they could. He kills all but one of them and saves a woman on that ship who is one of the Therns. He starts to finding out more of their odds against each other. So, and the woman is a priestess of the Holy Hecador, also his daughter. Her name's Fedor, a kind of spoiled little brat who does believe in her own divinity and so forth. And, you know, she is taking a fascination with John Carter, but in a spoiled brat sort of way. So he finally finds his way to the underground city of Omium, where he's taken prisoner. You know, they're all taken prisoner because Zodar, the Black Pirate he captured here, he's now disgraced. He used to be a high noble, but he's, you know, he's been disgraced because how could he lose to someone who's supposed to be inferior to him, you know, to them? So now John Carter and Zodar are now prisoners for the games, and Fedor is now the handmaiden for a year to Isis, where after the end, she, you know, after the end of the year, she's, you know, she loses her life. So it's all a dark end. But while they're captured, Carter meets up with another guy who is a, you know, a prisoner. He finds out that as his son Cthoris trying to search for his mother, if I recall. Let's see. And so yeah, so I think, you know, so they try and find a way to escape and reveal the forest that is Isis, that she's not divine and all that. They eventually escape, and they meet up with Tars Tarkas and Thuvia. Now Carter has a problem. When he comes back to Helium, he's now broken their, you know, he committed a taboo to where he's not supposed to come back from the Valley Door, near Tars Tarkas, so, but they're trying to convince them that there is a, that they need to be, they're not who they say they are, so they got that problem. Deja Thoris also has taken the river Is, you know, in the, you know, to meet her end, not knowing what all is going on, so Carter has to race against that. The Zadangas are trying to infiltrate back into Helium. They try and capture John Carter and say, you know, because of what he's done to them in the last book. So in all time, he's trying, you know, Carter, he finds out his father-in-law and his grandfather-in-law, Deja Thor's father and grandfather, they're trying to search for her, and they're ended up missing. So it's all this happening at once, all at the same time, trying to convince them to raise an army and go after the Therns, and, you know, and the firstborn. So, and it leaves off a cliffhanger where he finally almost gets to rescue the three women we come across to know, Thuvia, Deja Thoris, and Fedor, but they're now in a final attempt, and, you know, they get stuck in this prison that won't be opened up for a year, and Fedor is not exactly happy with Deja Thoris. She's quite jealous of her, and lifts up a cliffhanger like that. So that's the end of the, that's a, I may have gone too much at the end of the, of, you know, but hopefully the details will keep you interested and want to get into that. So that is The Gods of Mars by Edgar Rice Burroughs, second book of the John Carter series. Thank you all for watching, and have a nice day.